We interrupt this program for an important...
Yow!
I need to know how to fix Xbox One green screen of death.
Microsoft seems to suffer from a lot of screens of death. GSOD is not as common though.
GSOD can also mean grinding sound of death, but I think that's the drive. I do not know what this one is.
The green screen of death can occur when you are trying to run an update or cannot correct itself after an update.
I'm assuming that Microsoft would recommend a reboot to fix it. That's how they fix everything else.
If it won't get past the green startup screen, you may just want to wait. Microsoft says it can take up to 10 minutes for it to validate and verify everything.
I'm allowed to wonder what is going on. My gaming console should not have an existential crisis.
If you just unboxed it, it may take 10 minutes or more. If you did an update, anything more than 10 minutes they say to try to solve via a power cycle.
Also known as reboot.
They mean a hard reboot, as in power it down, unplug it, plug it in and turn back on.
I do not know if that's just extra work to make sure you wait 10 seconds for power to dissipate. Or buy some tech support guy another minute to think while the user is crawling on the floor looking for the plug.
If it still does not come up right, the next step is downloading the offline system update diagnostic tool onto a USB drive, and then running it on the console.
What if that does not work?
There's always the solution of mailing them the console to fix.
I might as well return it to the store.
Try downloading the OSUDT2 diagnostic tool first. And if you get it up, check the build history of updates to see which one went wrong.
I do not know how often it updates.
Microsoft is buggy, no matter how cool the console. If you get past the green screen of death via reboot or diagnostics, you'll probably need to do updates until the update process is complete.
Is there an updater for the updater?
You're thinking of Java.
What do you do if the green screen of death is on the new Xbox One?
Reboot it, do the diagnostic tool, and if that fails, take it in while the warranty is still in effect.
I've heard you have to wait to let it load.
Unless you're part of the Christmas rush to unbox the Xbox and literally a million other people are all connecting at the same time, it should not matter.